Hi guys, as usual it's me, Just a Voice Over, and you're watching Review Machines. It's early spring already, and we have a start of bicycle season now, and today we have Soul Curious bike to review. Actually, this bike is pretty standard, but it's equipped with a very interesting kit that has several huge advantages. The first one. This kit is suitable almost for any adult bike. The second, for this kit you can take any engine from a gas trimmer, and then if necessary you can put it back. And the third, with this kit bike's transmission still works, with shifting all gears. And finally, with this kit the bike is still quite light, and it's still possible to pedal it. As a matter of fact, all these features are just a theory, and today we are going to test them in practice, to find out if this kit is really good enough. Well, it's time to begin, let's do it! Well, let's look at the construction. As I said, we have a standard adult bike with a standard frame. Now you see the kit mounted on the frame. At the front part of the kit there is an engine. It's possible to use any engine from a gas trimmer, but we took the simplest and the cheapest motor, 1 HP 2-stroke 25cc. Frankly speaking, it's definitely not the best engine for this kit. And now you see the centrifugal clutch. It starts working approximately at 3000 RPM. There is a belt drive with three belts. The first one is external, the next belt is inside the frame. And finally the drive goes by a chain to the other running clutch that unites both engine and pedal momentum. The rear wheel is driven by the second chain through a standard bike's transmission. The body of the kit is made of a plywood, but I think it would be better to make it of something like carbon. There are two locks that fix the kit on the frame of the bike. To control the engine, there is a throttle on the handlebar and the button to stop it. As I said, one of the features of this kit is its lightweight. So let's wait. The result is 23 kilos, and I think it's a great result for a motorized bike, taking into account that the weight of the bike is about 16 kilos. Now let's see how all this gear works when it's moving. We see the pedal drive working as usually, so we can use the pedals with this kit. Now let's try to start the engine. Well, and the most interesting, let's see if the transmission works. It seems that it works pretty good, so I think it's high time to move to the practice. And I am looking forward to share with you my very first impressions, guys. And I think the idea of this project definitely works. It's so fun to ride quite a standard bike. And yes, it feels absolutely like a regular bike, maybe just a bit heavier. But the most curious, you can at any time start the engine, and its 1 horsepower will do all the job instead of you. My weight is 86 kilos. And I should say, this tiny motor surprisingly is able to move my weight without my help with pedals. But the huge advantage of this project – it's working transmission. It does a lot of good. For example, when I'm riding on this forest road, I put the lowest gear, and it provides good torque on rough terrain. As you can see, on a low gear it's possible to start moving without pedals. On the other hand, we still have a regular bike, and you can switch to the pedals at any moment. But we should take into account that now it's approximately 10% harder to pedal it than on a regular bike without kit. Then I should mention that it's possible to use an engine and pedal simultaneously. It's a kind of assist mode, like on electric bikes. Now let's move to the asphalt to see what this bike can show out there. First of all, meet the author of the project, it's Pasha. The main idea of his project is to make a kit that would be useful for those cyclists who love distant travels on their bikes. Electric bikes have numerous advantages, of course, but they still have one drawback – it's a limited range. So they may not be suitable for distant rides, but in our case, for example, we have been pedaling for a long time and got quite tired, but we won't stop for having a rest. Instead of that, we just start our engine and keep on moving. Now let's see how the shifting of the gears works on asphalt. It works perfectly. And now it's interesting to find out the maximum speed without pedals on high gear. As we can see, it's about 40 km per hour. To my mind, it's a decent result, taking into account that our kit is equipped with the weakest engine, and it's possible to use here much more powerful motors. Паша is 10 kilos lighter than me, and he literally flies on his bike through the forest. As to me, generally speaking, I like the idea of this kit, but I would rather change some things. Firstly, frankly speaking, plywood is not the best material for a body of the kit. It would be much better to make it of a carbon, for example. Then it's definitely better to use here more powerful engine, for higher speed and heavier riders. I think some 2 HP 4-stroke engine would fit here beautifully. Besides, it would work much quieter. And finally, it's easier to start 4-stroke motors, for sometimes it's not so simple here. For all that, this kit is definitely worth of our attention. Of course, it can turn almost any regular bike into a motorized bike. Still with working pedals and transmission, you can take any engine, it's very lightweight. All these features make this project quite a curious solution. But what about the price? How much can this kit cost? Unfortunately, this kit now is not serial production. The alpha of the project now is looking for investors. If it sometime goes to serial production, its price will be about $400. But it's not clear for now if this kit is interesting enough to be serial produced. What do you think, guys? If it's worth of it or no? Please post your comments. Well, besides, there is an idea to make a video comparison between this motorized bike and some electric bike. Would you like to see such a video? And now let's go today. Thanks for having a ride with us. Please consider subscribing to the channel if you like this video. Stay with us, it will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.